So first of all, how does a method look like? That is, what is the basic structure of a method in Java? Now so far we have seen the public static void main method having the argument of string array. And inside this main method, we use to write our code. Now whatever code that we write inside a method is actually known as the method body. So this is the basic structure of the method. Now what do we mean by the public static, void and this main function? So this public static is actually known as the modifier in Java. Now this public static can be the private static or only private or the protected. And this static part, I will come to it in our upcoming modules. So as of now, please don't worry about what does this static stands for. So whatever we write just before the void or the return type, it is actually known as the modifier of the method. And now next comes the void. Now this void is actually the return type in Java. So this simply signifies that this main method does not return anything. Now the void actually means nothing. So this method does not return anything at the end of this method, right? And now this main is actually the user-defined method. So we can say this main is actually the name of the method that we are dealing with. And this string array args is actually the formal parameters of this main method. So this is all about the structure of the methods in Java. Now from inside this main method, whatever code we write is actually known as the method body. So from inside this main method, we can also call a separate method or some other method, such as let us call add method to add these two numbers 2 and 3. Now this method can be defined like this: private static int add int a and int b. Now let us come to this private static part. It is again the modifier that we saw here, public static. And now let us come to int part. Now here in case of main method, we have void as the return type. But in case of add method, we have the return type of int. Now I will come to it shortly. And here this add is actually user defined. And it is actually the method name. So this method name we have here as add. And as a parameters, that is the formal parameters, we have integer a and integer b. Now always make sure the signature of this method add should match with this signature of add. That is, this 2 is actually the integer value and this 3 is actually the int value. So here it has to be a int a and int b. And here we cannot write string a and string b because we are actually passing the 2 and 3 as a parameter. So when this statement is executed, this 2 will appear in place of a and this 3 will appear in place of b. So inside this method, we got the value of int a as 2 and int b as 3. So now let us define int sum equal to a plus b and then return sum. So return is the keyword for this integer return type. So here return statement simply returns the integer sum value. So that is why in the return type we have int here. If we return the float value here, then it will be float here. If we return the string value here, then we have to define string here. As simple as that. So here this statement simply returns the sum of 2 and 3. And then inside the main function, we can utilize this sum variable or the sum of these two numbers and print it out inside this main method only. And now you must be thinking, why do we need this method? Why didn't we just add a and b right here inside the main method and print the value, right? Why do we need to have a specific add method and write all these code here? So here, let us come to this slide. Why do we need methods in Java? So on the left hand side, let us take an example. Sum 1 equal to 2 plus 3, sum 2 equal to 4 plus 9, and then print the value of sum 1 and print the value of sum 2. So here what we are doing is, we are adding 2 and 3, 4 and 9 and storing it in a separate variable of sum 1 and sum 2 and then print out the values. So in the output, we get 5 and 13 as the output. Fine, so this is the normal way of coding in Java. we have a method main, and inside this we just perform some operation, right? And now let us come to this part, right hand side, public static void main method, and here we have sum 1 equal to add 2 and 3, sum 2 equal to add 4 and 9. So here we are simply passing 2 and 3 as a parameter and 4 and 9 as a parameter, and then simply printing the value of sum 1 and sum 2. Now this method add is actually present here. Private static int sum, int a and int b return the sum of these two numbers, that is a plus b. So in the output again, we get the similar output 5 and 13. So comparing the left hand side with the right hand side, we can notice here we are performing 2 plus 3 and 4 plus 9 manually. But here we are just relying on the method of add method. So when this statement is executed, this simply calls this add method here. And by mistake, I have written sum here. So let me change it. So now we have add method here. Fine. So when this statement is executed, it simply calls this method. So this statement doesn't care what are the codes that we have written inside this add method. Fine. So it simply calls this method and we get the result inside the sum1 variable. And similar is the case of this sum2 variable. Simply call this method and get the result, right? But here on the left hand side, there is a chance of doing some mistake because we are actually repeating the code again and again. Here the codes are pretty simple, 2 plus 3. But imagine a situation where you have a very complex method. So the probability of doing the mistake by repeating the code again and again is very high. So that is why we use methods in Java. So here inside the IntelliJ IDE, let us explore the methods or functions in Java with the help of a simple program. Write a program to find if a number is even or it is an odd number. So for that, we already know that we have to write the if condition. If the number modulus 2 is equal to 0, then the number is actually even, right? So sout simply print it is even, or else it is actually odd number. Now, suppose I want to check if the number is 4. So if the 4 is actually even or not. So here we can simply print 4 is even and 4 is odd. And now suppose if I ask you to check if the number 5 is even or not. So for that again, you will repeat the same code. So Ctrl C and Ctrl V. Now instead of using 4 here, let us change it to 5, right? So 5 is even and 5 is odd. So let us now run our code. So in the output console, we have 4 is the even number and 5 is the odd number. So we are getting the right output inside the output console. Now, you must have noticed that we are actually repeating the same code again and again. What if I ask you to find if number 6 is even or odd? Or if the number 7 is actually an odd number or the even number. So for that again, you have to repeat the code again and again to find out if the numbers are odd or even, right? Now here, the concept of methods comes into picture. By using the methods in Java, we can minimize our code. Or you can say, we can simply remove the redundant code. So here, just outside the main method, we can simply create a method such as is even. Now to define a method in Java, we always start a method name with the help of the small letter is even. So when you read this method is even, you simply check if the number is even or not. And now it is simply showing some error, invalid method declaration, return type is required. So just before the method name, we actually give the return type. So let us call our return type as void. So currently, we don't want to return anything, right? And now, here, just before the void, we have to define the modifier such as private static void is even. Now, we will talk about the private modifier or the static modifier in a lot more detail when we will enter the object-oriented programming in Java in our upcoming modules. So as of now, please don't worry much about this. So private static void even, and now here it is showing again some error that method should have a body and that body should exist in between the curly braces, right? So here we have to put our code. like we have inserted the code inside the main method. Fine. So here, what we will do inside this isEvent method, let us copy this code from here and let us paste it inside this. And now here, let us replace it by num, here num again, and here as well. And now here it shows that int num is actually undefined. So what we are going to do is, as a parameter inside this method, we will define int num. Now this rectifies our error. So how can we use this method inside the main method? So what we will do, we are simply going to replace these four lines of code by isEven method and simply pass 4 as a parameter. And similarly here as well, simply replace it by isEven and pass 5 as a parameter. Now suppose you want to check isEven 6 and even you want to check isEven if the number 11 is even or odd. So you can do it very easily. So now let us run our code. So here we go in the output console. We have 4 is a even, 5 is a odd, 6 is even and 11 is odd. So just by writing one method, you can check as many numbers as you want to if the number is even or odd, right? So this is the beauty of using methods in Java. And now here, let us move a step ahead and let us talk about this return type. And now suppose instead of void, if I use something different such as, let's say return type as string object. Now here, you can see it is showing some error, missing return statement. Now earlier it was void, so we did not return anything from this method. But if you write here string or int or float value, something like that, then it will simply expect you to return some value, that is a string value. Fine, so let us return a blank string here. Now, if we are returning something here, then that return value will appear here. Let's say string result equal to isEven. Fine. So this isEven actually returns a string value. So currently, we are returning a blank string value. Now, let us try something different. Let us try to return this string value and print it inside the main method itself. So here what I will do inside the isEven method, let us use string str and then here I will simply replace this method by str equal to num is even or num is odd. Fine. So now instead of printing if the number is even or odd inside this method itself, we are going to print it inside this main method. So here string result equal to is even and let us print the result string. And also here I forgot to remove this empty string. So simply return string str here. And now let us execute our code. So here we get 4 is even. Now this time this statement is actually getting printed here right inside the main method. Now earlier it was getting printed inside the is even method. And now, similarly, you can find string, let's say result2 equal to isEven, let's say 37. And then simply print R2 here. Let us run our code. So in the output, again, we get 37 is odd, which is getting printed inside the main method. And now, we can further optimize this code. So here, what we will do, instead of storing the return value inside the result string, we can simply cut it from here, Control X, and replace this string variable with isEven 4. And let us remove this statement. And similarly, let us remove it from here and place it in place of R2. So here, this optimizes our code further. So inside this method, we are calling another method isEven. Now remember, println is actually a method. So you can call a method inside a method, such as println is a method, and inside this method as a parameter we are passing isEven. Now this method is actually present here, fine. So this will simply return a string. So here we will get a string value in place of this method. Now this string value will further be passed inside this println method. and we will get the desired result inside the output console. Fine. So I hope now you know how do we define methods in Java and what are the advantages of using the methods inside the Java, right? So this was all about the demo video of methods in Java.